Laudetur Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ, and welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square here in Rome, where the Holy Father will soon appear at that window where the red banner is hung to recite the Angelus with those who've gathered here from all over the world. Today is the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. As you can see, we have clear skies here, but extremely warm. I'd like to welcome all of you who are joining us today. Those of you joining us from various Vatican media channels, maybe the Vatican audio app, or the Vatican News web portal, or the YouTube channel. You're joining all these people now waiting here in St. Peter's Square. Some of you are joining us through television from EWTN, Shalom World TV, CBS in London, and Catholic TV. Welcome to all of you. And then many more of you are joining us through radio stations and other internet sites throughout the world. Welcome as we together recall the wonderful miracle of the Incarnation, and in the beautiful prayer that we will say, it says the Father himself announces the incarnation of his Son. What joy every father has in telling people that he's going to have a first child. Well, that's something that this prayer is telling us, that God the Father himself announces the joy of the incarnation of his Son who came among us. And here we have a close-up of that window where very, very shortly Pope Francis will appear. And he will impart his apostolic blessing, which all of us receive as well, the plenary indulgence attached to that blessing. So we prepare ourselves for that, and perhaps this week we can include confession and communion as well as the prayer of the Creed, and then prayers for our Holy Father in order to obtain that special indulgence, which we can apply either to ourselves or to someone else, perhaps, and we know who has died. It's just past, a few seconds past 12 now, and any moment our Holy Father should appear here at this window. We see everything prepared. This is a weekly appointment, which the Holy Father hardly ever misses. He continues also when he is away from Rome. And so pilgrims from all over the world know that they can come here and expect to hear our Holy Father some words, usually on the day's gospel. And many fewer pilgrims in Rome because it's still the period of summer vacation. All of these people gathered here expecting also to be able to receive the blessing, as I mentioned. And any religious articles that they have too will be blessed here today. Our Holy Father has been taking somewhat of a break from his normal schedule, and this past week he once again began receiving people in audience. We hear the cries of those anxiously awaiting his appearance here. along with the weekly recitation of the Angelus. Pilgrims can generally see the Holy Father on Wednesday during his general audience. And it's an opportunity for the Holy Father to provide catechesis. And he's been following the Acts of the Apostles. He's just recently concluded one on the commandments, and he did one on the Our Father. This is important for the Holy Father in his role as the primary pastor, the vicar of the Universal Church. And on Sundays in a particular way, he presents some thoughts from the day's gospel, today being the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Many of you probably have memories of trips to Rome, having come here and waited under this same window. Generally, the square is a bit more crowded. Many Romans, as I said, are still outside of Rome, and others in Italy vacationing in other places. And as we know, the Holy Father is going to be beginning another apostolic journey this week, as has been publicized. He will be going to 3 countries in southern Africa, bringing his message as the Vicar of Christ to people who themselves, very many of them, will never be able to journey here to Rome. And so we can include him in our prayer today, and all the people who will be participating in his journey. Imagine their excitement as they prepare, and venues are being set up right now, and last-minute preparations being made. So we pray for the countries of Mozambique and Madagascar and Mauritius. These are the 3 countries who will be receiving our Holy Father this week. And we can hear the murmur of the crowd here as they, many of them with umbrellas, shielding themselves from the sun. It's pretty direct sunlight right now. Waving flags of various nations. Again, as we await the arrival of Pope Francis here at the window in order to take part in the weekly recitation of the Angelus, a centuries-old prayer. Many of us, when we were in grade school, may remember if we had the blessing of having religious sisters in school, we would stop at midday and pray that beautiful prayer. And in a way, it's a beautiful reminder for us that in the midst of any normal day, our Lord can break in as he did with Our Lady and allow us to experience in a very special way a special incarnation of our Lord. All of us as Christians, of course, called to incarnate Christ within us through the grace that we've received at baptism. And it sounds like here he is. He's now here, and he's greeting the crowds.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good day.
Prima di tutto devo scusarmi del ritardo.
Before all else, I need to ask pardon for my being late. He remained closed. He remained closed in the elevator for 20 minutes. It was without electricity. So thank God the firefighters came, and he's thanking them. After 25 minutes, they were able to get the elevator working again. So he's asking everyone to applaud the firefighters who helped him out. This Sunday's Gospel shows us Jesus taking part in a banquet in the house of a leader of the Pharisees. And he was observing how the guests were running to get the top places. This is a rather widespread attitude even today, and not only when we're invited to a meal. Habitually, we seek the top place to affirm an alleged superiority over others. In reality, this race for the first places hurts the community, whether it be civil or ecclesial, because it ruins fraternity. All of us know those persons who are always trying to get higher, higher and higher. They hurt fraternity. They wound fraternity. Faced with that scene, Jesus recounts two brief parables. The first is addressed to the one who is invited to a banquet and exhorts that person not to put himself or herself in the top place, because he says, a more distinguished guest than you may have been invited by him, and the host who invited both of you may approach you and say, give your place to that person. And then you would proceed with embarrassment to take the lowest place. Instead, Jesus teaches us to have the opposite attitude. When you are invited, go and take the lowest place, so that when the host comes to you, he may say, my friend, move up to a higher position. Therefore, we should not seek on our own initiative the attention and consideration of others, but rather let others give it to us. Jesus always shows us the way of humility. We need to learn the way of humility, because that is the most authentic one, which also allows us to have authentic relationships, real humility, not fake humility. The one that in the Piedmont, they have a term for it. I didn't get it. But the true humility. In the second parable, Jesus addresses the one who invites, and referring to the way of selecting those invited to the feast, he tells him, when you offer a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, the blind. Blessed indeed will you be because of their inability to repay you. Here too, Jesus goes completely against the tide, manifesting, as always, the logic of God the Father. And he also adds the key to interpreting his speech. And what's that key? It's a promise. If you do that, you will be repaid at the resurrection of the righteous. This means that whoever behaves in this way will have the divine reward, much higher than any human exchange expected. Human exchange, in fact, usually distorts relationships, introducing personal interest into a relationship that should be generous and free, Instead, Jesus instead invites us to selfless generosity to open the way for a much greater joy, that of being partakers in God's own love. And may the Virgin Mary, the humblest and highest of creatures, help us to recognize ourselves as we are, that is, small, and to rejoice in giving without something in return.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuo.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Il verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Udini et ficiamum promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, qui angelo nunciante, Christi fili tui incarnatione coniovim, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionem gloriam perducamur. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis, Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucet eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunque nosque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fece caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Amen.
And the crowd reacting to the reception of the apostolic blessing of Pope Francis, which we too have had the blessing of receiving.
Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters,
oggi, primo settembre,
today, the 1st of September, is the World Day of Prayer for the Care of Creation. It's an ecumenical prayer which raises the awareness and commitment to protect our common home, starting from a more sustainable personal and family lifestyle. From today until the 4th of October, the Feast of St. Francis of Assisi, it's a time conducive to praise God for all of His creatures. And the assumption of responsibility in the face of the cry of the earth. I greet all of you from Italy and from various parts of the world. In particular, I greet the Ukrainian pilgrims, praise be Jesus Christ, he says, who have come from different countries on the occasion of the Synod of Bishops of the Ukrainian Greek Catholic Church, which will take place in Rome in the coming days. I greet the sisters and the young people in formation at the Institute of St. Joseph Benedict Cottolengo. Thank you. Thank you for your witness. Thank you for what you do and for what you
avanti,
teach us.
Avanti.
Keep going ahead.
I ciclisti di Cunardo,
the cyclists of Cunardo and the faithful of Cerro di Botanuco, The group of Catholic Action from Lecce. And the young people of San Matteo, St. Matthew of the Decima. Next Wednesday, God willing, I will leave for an apostolic trip to Africa to visit the people of Mozambique, Madagascar, and Mauritius. I ask you to accompany me in prayer so that this pastoral visit may bring the desired fruits. Next October 5th, there will be a consistory for the nomination of 10 new cardinals, and the choice symbolizes the international aspect of the Church and the necessity to bring the mercy of God to all peoples of the world. And he's going to say their names right now.
Miguel Ángel Ayuso Guixot, Presidente del Pontificio Consiglio,
President of the Pontifical Council for Interreligious Dialogue.
José Tolentino Mendoza, Archivista y Bibliotecario,
the Archivist of the Library of the Holy Roman Church. Archbishop of Jakarta.
Monsignore Juan de la Caridad García Rodríguez, Archivescovo de San Cristóbal de la Habana.
Monsignor Havana and
Ambonco Besungu,
Archbishop of Kinshasa in the Congo.
Jean-Claude Hollerich, Archivescovo de Luxemburgo.
The Archbishop of Luxembourg.
Alvaro Ramazzini y Meri, Vescovo di Huehuetenango. Monsignore Matteo Zuppi, Archivescovo di Bologna.
The Archbishop of Bologna.
Cristóbal López Romero, Archivescovo di Rabat.
The Archbishop of Rabat.
Michael Cerny, Sottosegretario della Sezione Migranti,
Undersecretary of the Migrants and Refugees Section. He's a Jesuit priest. Michael Cerny. He will be adding two archbishops and a bishop who have distinguished themselves for their service to the Church.
Monsignore Michael Luis Fitzgerald, Archivescovo Emerico di Nepte.
Archbishop Emeritus.
Monsignore Sigitas Tamkevicius, Archivescovo Emerito di Kaunas.
And an Archbishop Emeritus of Kaunas.
Eugenio Dal Corso, Vescovo Emerito di Benguela.
And a Bishop Emeritus of,
per I nuovi cardinali,
I think he said Bengal, but I'm not sure. We pray for these newly nominated cardinals that they might help me as in my ministry as the Bishop of the Church of Rome and all the holy faithful of God. And to all of you, I wish you a pleasant Sunday. Please don't forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch, and we'll see you again. And so ends the live broadcast of the recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis in St. Peter's Square. The Pope has released a video message in beginning of his trip to Mozambique. And today, his message for the World Day of Prayer for the Care of Creation will be released. And you'll be able to find a list of those names of cardinals that the Holy Father is nominating. You want to check these out on the Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube, where you will also find a summary of today's Angelus. And later this week, complete coverage of Pope Francis' upcoming trip to Mozambique, Madagascar, and Mauritius. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank all of the technicians who made this broadcast possible, and for all of you for joining us. A blessed Sunday to you all. Laudetur Jesus Christus.